elevator. And then we'll get started and sit on your elevator, crisscross applesauce.
We can do any elevator.
Yeah.
No.
We can go get an elevator. Okay, I'm going to mute us so we can all hear the music. Are you on your elevator? All right, back up so I can see your whole body. Here we go. There's my elevator. Let me make it sure you can see me. All right, are you ready to take a ride on our elevator? All right, so crisscross applesauce. Okay, Julia, I don't mind if you're sitting in that chair, but just make sure you have room around it to dance, okay? All right, sit up tall, dancers. Let me see that good posture. All right, remember, we're going to work on our musicality. So, when on the first floor, we're going to tap our knees.
Press the button, four, going to the four, going to the four,
having a stick.
There's an elephant saying, stop your feet with me.
He's that strong, it's just good.
Now stop me walk. We need to go to the elevator.
Let's do our If You're Happy and You Know It. Hey, I'm going to move my elevator out of the way.
Do you need to move your elevator out of the way? Okay, well, I'm going to take off my sweatshirt. I was getting my heart rate up. That's awesome. Okay, here we go. Remember, our first one, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, number two is stomp your feet. Stomp, stomp. And then number three, shout, hooray! Good. All right, and then we'll put all three together. All right, I want to see your heels glued together. Okay, what is something that's really sticky? Bubble gum? Let's put some bubble gum on our feet and glue it together. All right, so we're going to do a demi-plie, arms match our legs. We're also going to do a port de bras, which means we're going to move our arms up. We're going to look at our hand, other hand, and then stretch to open, and then flip your wrist to come down very gracefully. Here we go. Glue those heels together.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it's not your teeth, stop, stop. If you're happy and you know it's not your teeth, stop, stop. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it's not your teeth, stop, stop.
Right, big jump, ready?
If you're happy and you know it's
thumbs. We're not like robots dancing, right? So tuck those thumbs in and then And watch, let's make our arms grow. Ready? Uh-oh, here they go. Grow, grow, grow. Uh-oh, but guess what? Let me show you my body from the side. Are my arms in front of my body or next to my body? This is next to my body, right? This is in front. So your arms are actually still in front of your body. So what? Watch what happens when I bring my arms too far back. It makes my belly stick out or my shoulders droop. So make sure you stay pulled up, rounded arms, lifted elbows, okay? All right, let's do a little balance. See what if you have good balance today, ready? Tandu, show me a beautiful pointed toe. Good, and make sure I can see your heel. Do you remember when I drew Mr. Smiley Face on my heel? And he was smiling when he could see you, and he was frowny face when he couldn't see you. Make sure you can see that heel, okay? Now drag it in like it's going through really thick mud. Drag, drag, drag. Did it come back in? Awesome, let's try the other side, ready? Uh-oh, guess what? I think there's some bubble gum on the bottom of our shoe. Can we try to get it off? Push your foot into the ground. Ready? Push, 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 push. Oh, good. And then drag it and get that gum off. Drag it in. Good job. We're going to do that on both sides, and then we're going to wash the floor and do a passe balance in the number four. Here we go, everybody. Okay, ready? Hold your small ball. First position. Ready? Tandu. Ooey, ooey. Gimme. Let me see that heel. Ooh, nice. Straight knee and drag it in. Show me, Millie. Let's get the gum off our shoe. Ready? Ooey, ooey, gimme. Show me your nice pointed toes and drag it in. One more, last time. Ready? Ooey, ooey, gooey. Let's open our arms. Put that heel down. Wave to me. Hello. Are your toes pointing out? I don't want them coming forward. Make sure they're out to the side. All right, make sure those knees stay straight. Let's wash the floor. Ready? Wash, wash, wash. Wash the floor some more. Wash, wash, wash the floor. Time to point your toe and make the number four. Can you balance? Make sure those arms are round. Ready? Cross from your belly button. Okay, let's try the other side. Wave to me. Hello. Good job, Adeline. Nice balance. Uh-oh, make sure your toes are out. Let's wash the floor on the other side. Ready, go. Wash, wash, wash the floor. Wash, 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 wash the floor. Time to make the number. Uh-oh, we're going to bring our arms up this time. Four. Round your arms. Oh, fight for that balance. Good, Millie. Awesome. And let's melt down to the ground. Stay on your feet. All right, let's get a little tiny kernel of popcorn. Ready? Say it, clap with me.
You put the oil in the pot and you let it get hot. You put the popcorn in it and you start to grin. Sizzle,
pop. All right, hop down. All right, put your feet up. Can you wave high to your toes? Hello. Beatrice, I can't see you anymore. I just see your ceiling. It's a very nice ceiling, but I'd rather see you. Keep it going. All right, show me your awesome pointed toes.
Thank you.
Make sure you can see the screen so you can see all my characters. Make sure you have space around you because you have to help me. Okay, so remember I told you it was about this funny guy. I don't know why I make him laugh like that. He just looks like he would sound like that. All right, guess what his name is. I'm only gonna tell you once and you have to remember it because you have to help our special friend at the end of our story. All right, his name is Rumpelstiltskin. Isn't it so silly? Do you guys know the story? All right, if you know it, it might be a little different because I'm changing it to so we can dance, but it's the same gist of the story, okay? All right, once upon a time, there was a really nice, friendly old man. And he did not have many riches, not a lot of wealth, but he had a beautiful daughter. And he thought, well, if I had some riches, I think maybe we would be happier. But nonetheless, he was very happy and he worked on his farm. And then he was out working in the farm one day and a horse came riding by. Stand up. Can you show me your horse? Oh, hey, hold on one second. Let me put on some fun story music for us and we'll ride our horse. Do you know what horses do? Horses do a gallop. Let's see if we can gallop like a horsey. Still just a little. All right, show me your gallop. Good. Guess who was riding on that horse? There was a king. A king was riding on the horse and he rode by the old man's farm and the old man stopped him and he said, oh, Mr. King, I have something very important to tell you. Oh, Adrian, you look like you are the king. Well, I have a beautiful daughter that has magic powers. She is a ballerina and she dances, and really amazing things happen when she dances. Would you like to meet her? And he said, well, what kinds of amazing things happen when she dances? Well, when my daughter dances, she can turn straw into gold. He's like, what? I have to meet her and see this to believe it for myself. So he calls, oh, daughter. And she comes out and she says, well, hi, father. And he says, well, I would like you to meet somebody. This is the king. And I told him about your magic powers, about how when you dance, you can turn straw into gold. And the king would like you to go to his castle and show him your magic powers. Okay, so she agrees to go with the king. So she follows him all the way to the castle. But when he puts her in a room, he shows her a big pile of straw. And she gets a little bit nervous because guess what? She really doesn't know how to turn straw into gold. And so she starts to cry. How would you cry if you were that pretty girl? So just then, this little funny man comes out and he says, why are you crying? And she says, well, I am kind of in a bind. The king thinks that I can turn that pile of straw into gold. And I don't know how. I do know how to dance, but I don't know how to turn straw into gold. And he says, well, I have magic powers. If I do this for you, what will you give me? And she says, well, I have a necklace. I could give you my necklace. And he said, okay, very well. And he goes over and he dances on the pile of straw. All right, you guys have to help me so we can turn this into gold. Are you ready? All right, so stand up. Let me find our music. We have to have very special music to turn it into gold. All right, here's our dance. Are you ready? So our dance is, and we're going to pretend there's straw all around us. And we're going to have our hands, actually that's around our arms like we were practicing before. I'll just hold them down though. We're going to do four little jumps, four little sautés, and our heels are going to come back together like this. One, two, three, four, and then we're going to jump with our feet wide and keep them out. One, so our second position, two, stretch those knees, reach up, three, four, and then in and out. That's our échappé, in and out. Then number three is a little different. Watch me, in and up, and soutenu. And then we open, and then we look and see if we turn the hand to straw. Are you ready? All right, do it with me. Glue those heels together. Ready? Arms rounded, plie. One, two, three, four. Jump wide. One, two, three, four. In and out. Échappé. Échappé. In and out. In and up. Soutenu. And then, she looks and guess what she sees? Before her eyes, she sees the pile of straw. All of a sudden, guess what? It turns into gold. Can you believe it? Oh my goodness, this little man does have some really awesome powers, doesn't he? So the king, shortly thereafter, comes into the room and he sees the big pile of gold. And he says, oh, you are a magical dancer. I can't believe it. Okay, well, I'm gonna move you to another room and this pile is gonna be even bigger, more straw, because you're gonna turn it into more gold. Well, how do you think she feels? You think she's excited? No, she's sad, crying. She says, I don't know how to turn straw into gold. It was that funny little man. And then poof, here he comes again. And he says, why are you crying? And she says, well, look, now I even have a bigger pile of straw, and I don't know how to dance and turn it into gold. Well, if I help you again, what will you give me? She says, well, the only thing I have left is this ring. I have this ring. Would that work? And he says, okay. So he does his little dance. Are you ready? Will you help me do it one more time? Here we go. And then the princess looks at the pile of hay. And all of a sudden, look, it turned it into gold again. Can you believe it? Oh my goodness. So then the king comes and sees an even bigger pile of gold. And he is like, yippee! Thank you. Okay, but now I'm gonna take you to even a bigger room. And if you can turn this really super duper big pile of straw into gold, I will make you my wife. And he leaves. Well then, wouldn't you know, even more straw. And now she's really sad. Where's that little man? Where is he? Where did he go? And poof, here he comes again. And he says, let me guess, you need my help. She says, yes, but I have nothing left to give you. Although, the king said that if I turn this pile of straw into gold, he will make me his queen. And I can give you all the riches in the world. Well, he says, no, I don't want all the riches in the world. I want your firstborn baby. Well, she was really in a bind. She didn't know what to do, so she agreed, hoping that that little man would just disappear and forget. But sure enough, he goes to help her turn that straw into gold. Let's do it one last time. Are you ready? All right, stand up. Help me jump. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Suck it. Show me that big plie. Good. In and out. In and out. A, stop. Hey, in and out. In and up. And uh-oh, should we see if it worked? What do you think? Do you think it worked? Okay, let's look. Oh, it worked! Yay, it worked a third time. So guess what? The king married the pretty girl. And oh, they had such a beautiful home and she had all the riches in the world. And then one day, she had a cute little baby. Wah, wah, goo goo gaga. And she was so happy. Oh, look at the baby. It's like as big as she is. It was a big baby. Okay. Uh-oh. Then one night, guess who appears? That funny little man. And he says, I'm here to take your baby. And she says, no. You can't really take your baby. Please have mercy. And he feels a little bad, but he says, okay, on one condition. And within 2 days, you have to guess my name. And if you can't guess my name, the baby is mine. And he goes away. And she thinks really hard. Did he ever tell me his name? What is his name? Is it Joe? No. Is it Mike? No, is it Harry? No, I just don't know. So she tells the king and everybody in the kingdom to be on the lookout for a funny little man. Well, that night, this little funny man was seen by a messenger of the king. He was dancing around a fire and he was singing a song that went, today I brew, tomorrow I bake, and after that, the child I'll take. Never can the queen guess that Rumpelstiltskin is my name. And the messenger heard it and went and told the queen. And then that night when Rumpelstiltskin came back and said, okay, I'm here to take your baby unless, can you guess my name? She said, well, let me see. Is your name Joe? He says, no. Is it Tom? No. Is it Mike? No. Is it, well, the only other name I can think of is Rumpelstiltskin. Is it Rumpelstiltskin? And he says, oh, yes, it is. And he gets so mad. He stomp all the way down into the floor. And he was never heard of or from ever again. The end. Take your bow. All right, you guys did a great job turning that straw into gold. Did you like my story? All right, let's finish with our reverence. Let's do our little star dance, and then we will curtsy and bow, and we will say goodbye. And hey, we have one more class left, and then I'll be in touch with Mom and Dad about what we're going to do for Peter Pan. But back up into your space. Let's do our dance. Guys, ready? All right, here we go, my cutie pies. Funny when I sit. Okay, last time. Here we go. Back up. Rewind.
I love you.
I love you all. All right, have a